Welcome to Throwback. I can hear most of you wondering, throwback? What is throwback? Why is this important to me? Let me answer these questions first. We often wish that our life must be filled with love, happiness, and peace. But are we able to lead such a life? But when we pause for a second and examine whether we are able to practice all the 9 fruits of the spirit, the answer would mostly be no, it's impossible. We are going to find out how to change such impossibilities into possibilities through this throwback series. And at the beginning, we are going to see about love. This is the first one of the fruit of the spirit. Many of you might be wondering what new I got to tell about an emotion that has been part and parcel of everybody's life. All of you love your parents, siblings and friends. You never fail to show them your affection and care. But are you able to show the same kind of love to the team leader or manager who's trying to corner you at the office? Are you able to love your most hateful enemy who wishes to see you fall down and get destroyed in life? I can hear some of you say, "Stop kidding, man. I'm not a reincarnation of Mother Teresa to love people who spit in my face." I do understand that this is close to impossible and loving such people is not easy. Having said that, loving our dear ones alone can't be counted as fullness of love. It can be attained only at the point where we begin to love our enemies in the same way. As a first step for that, do a small self-evaluation. Make a list of people you hate, dislike, and whom you are unable to love. Just think about one special quality in each one of them. The second step is forgiving their mistakes. Well, this can very well be called the toughest step of the process. But take your time. Gradually let go of your ego, grudge, anger, and start to love them for getting their sins. As a start to that, bless them even though they have cursed you, sworn at you, or even done something grave that ruined your life. When you begin to bless them, the anger in your heart starts to reduce without your knowledge. Whenever you get a chance, help them without a second thought. Last yet the most important part, do continue to pray for them. If you're wondering that these steps are too hard for you and you could never love your enemies in such a way, Lord Jesus Christ can help you change into a person who exhibits nothing but fullness of love. Just seek His help and start taking small steps towards that. You'll surely begin to experience the fullness of love in your life. You might have had many moments in your life where you weren't able to showcase love at all. Just put them in a huge sack and throw them behind your back and step forward to lead a life of love with the support of Jesus. Yes, this is indeed possible. As the Bible says, "But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do good to those who hate you, and pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you." And we know that the Bible never gives us an impossible command. So keep smiling, keep loving. See you on the next episode of Throwback.